Have you ever felt like your energy is getting drained when you hang around with certain people, or do you feel like you're not able to grow when you're with certain people? This might be because they're toxic for you. Toxic people are those people who gain access to your self-esteem and dignity and destroy them, leaving you completely doubting yourself and your ability to deal with the world. If you want to know more about them, do watch the video. Highly likely that you might have already encountered someone who seemed to be toxic. It is not very easy to recognize them because they are very good at confusing others. If you have recognized them, then good job, because not everyone can do, or they do not have the courage to do it. How do people become toxic? Toxic people are those people who, in response to stresses and traumas in their own life, try to create negativity and distresses for others. These people are usually people who do not feel good about themselves and have an unconscious urge to bring other people down. I will be explaining the different types and traits that are considered to be toxic in this video. But before that, let me tell you that we all possess some of these characteristics in low levels. The so-called toxic people may not be toxic for everyone, and also the toxicity may depend on the situation. Ultimately, people become toxic because they have something hidden within them, like an inferiority complex or fear of something which they aren't aware of. What are the different types of toxic people? Let us go through some of the toxic people that you often come across in the society. The extreme idealist. Not all idealists are toxic, but the one that I'm trying to mention here are the ones who seem to be really hardworking but have trust issues and so cannot delegate their tasks to others, and also have difficulties micromanaging, thus training themselves and others who are working with them. The bully. You might be more familiar to them. These are the people who do not follow any rules and regulations, as they feel that following such conventions are for the weak and the losers. These people have a biting sense of humor, and if you go against them, you become the target of this vicious humor. The victim. These people seem to be intelligent and sensitive. They usually seem to be sad, but you're drawn to them with the want to help them. Once you associate with them, the problem that you notice is that their sensitivity goes only inwards. They are drawn to playing the victim. The dramatic. They seem to have unusual energy and have a lot of stories to tell. They seem to be fun until the drama turns ugly. The more you get to know them, the more you hear stories of battle and bickering, always positioning themselves as the victim.
I was going this way and then suddenly a bike came from there, and then I was almost going to overtake the bike, and then this happened. I don't know what to do. This is really, really dangerous situation.
The boaster. These people have the ability to fascinate you with their ideas and plans. But before you indulge with them, take a few steps back and observe their past records. The charmer. These people seem to be extremely nice and considerate until you get to know them thoroughly. Once you get to know them, you will realize that their niceness is not out of genuine affection, but it is a defense mechanism. You will soon realize that they are really good at talking behind your back. The Good Samaritan. These people always appear when you're in trouble to save you. You feel extremely happy to have met them until they start showing their need to control you. If they do not show this need, then they're noble, but if they do, it is time for you to get out of there. The envious. These people are never satisfied with what they have. Spending time with them will make you start doubt your own self-esteem. The judgmental. There are people who share their opinions out of genuine care for you, and then there are the judgmentals who make you feel that the things that you're really passionate about are something that you should feel terrible about. They do not like people who are different from them. The twisted. These are the most easiest to spot. They are there with you when they need something, or they do not show any interest towards you. How do you know if you are around toxic people? If you feel drained when you're hanging around with certain people, maybe you are around toxic people.
Come on, let us go to the party.
If you often feel judged for the things that you like. If they are self-absorbed and cannot understand your needs. If you feel controlled. If they constantly make you feel bad. Not every relationship breaks because one of them is toxic. Sometimes a relationship doesn't work because there was no connection between them. It is important to remember to look at ourselves as well and not just the others. We need to learn to introspect, to look out for any toxic behavior and weed them out. We cannot always organize people into exact categories of toxic personality, as people might possess varying degrees of each type of toxic behavior. In any relationship, it is important that you understand yourself and the others thoroughly. You should understand whether you are helping each other grow or act as a hindrance for the other person. The more you understand yourself and the others, the better. If you like this video, do click on the like button, and if you are not yet a subscriber and want to see similar videos, do not forget to subscribe. If you want to talk to me about the video or discuss anything regarding the video, leave a comment below, or you can also contact me at my email address.